night, eh? Hey, Billy. Come on, you.
The line through Bristol Parkway was originally opened in 1913 as part of the Great Western Railway's Badminton Line from Wootton Bassett to Patchway, a shortcut for trains from London to South Wales, avoiding Bath and Chippenham. The station was built on the site of the Stoke Gifford Marshall Yard, which closed on the 4th of October 1971, having become surplus to requirement with the cessation of wagon-load freight trains. The station's development was seen as a response to the potential growth of housing and commercial developments in North Bristol, with proximity to the M4 and M5 motorway interchange at Almondsbury so important. The name Parkway came from the proximity to the M32 motorway, known as the Bristol Parkway, although the term Parkway has since been applied to park and ride stations throughout the United Kingdom. When the station was built, it was outside of the developed urban area, but the growth of housing and commercial development in the adjoining areas of the North Fringe had brought it within the conurbation, with many large office complexes nearby. The station, owned by British Rail, opened on the 1st of May 1972, and services were operated by the Western Region until British Rail was split up into business-led sectors in the 1980s, after which Parkway was served by the Intercity and Regional Railway subdivisions. The original structures, built by Stone & Company of Bristol, were basic, two island platforms connected by an open metal footbridge, with a wood and brick building containing the booking office facilities and waiting rooms. Platform 1, the current Platform 3, was on the north side of the tracks, as for trains towards London and Birmingham, and Platform 2 was for trains towards Wales and Bristol Temple Meads. The platforms were 256 metres in length, and the station opened with a 600-space car park and the fastest journey to London of 95 minutes, which was subsequently reduced to the 75 minutes when introduction of new high-speed trains in 1976. Platform canopies were added in 1973, along with a cover for the footbridge. Further minor improvements were implemented over the next 30 years, including a new booking office and extensions to the car park. Following the privatisation of British Rail in 1997, services at Bristol Parkway were franchised between several different train companies. The South Wales mainline services were provided by Great Western Trains, which was later rebranded First Great Western. Services from Bristol and Birmingham and the North were operated by Virgin Cross Country, and local services were franchised to Wales and Wests, which is in turn succeeded in 2001 by Wessex Trains. The Wessex franchise was amalgamated with the Great Western franchise into the Great Western franchise from 2006 and were awarded to First Great Western, which became known as Great Western Railway in 2016. Virgin Cross Country service was taken over by Arriva Cross Country in 2007. In August of 1998, the Royal Mail began construction of a mail terminal to the east of the station, taking over some of the station car park to provide a platform and warehouse for postal trains. The 12,000-square-foot building opened on the 15th of May 2000, replacing a similar facility at Bristol Temple Meads, with the Royal Mail stating it will be saved 250,000 miles of lorry journeys per year on local roads. However, the depot closed only 4 years later in 2004 when the Royal Mail ceased to use the rail network. Royal Mail offered the terminal to be used by freight companies, but as there were no takers, it was demolished in 2007. In 2008, Network Rail opened a maintenance training centre on the site within a £2.5 million project, which saw the construction of a mezzanine floor, a welding workshop and a 400-square-foot extension. In 2000, work began on a complete redevelopment of the station building with a new enclosed footbridge. It opened on the 1st of July 2001 and featured lifts and a generally enhanced facilities. Local roads were enhanced to help speed passengers' journeys to and from the station, and a new multi-storey car park was built to replace the spaces lost to the Royal Mail facility. A dedicated bus interchange was opened in 2003, and in 2006 construction started on a new 278-metre-long platform face on the north side of Platform 1 to ease congestion for trains towards Birmingham and London. The new platform, Platform Number 4, was opened on the 9th of May 2007 by Rail Minister Tom Harris. As part of the reconstruction, the waiting room at the east end of Platform 1 was demolished and replaced with an extended waiting area and customer help desk. Platform 1 was subsequently redesignated Platform Number 3, and the work cost £3 million and was funded by Network Rail, with First Great Western contributing £100,000 towards the new waiting room and help desk. Despite the large car park, the increase in passenger numbers at Parkway in recent years has led to problems with on-street parking, leading to the commissioning of a new 200-space car park 500 metres east of the station. It opened in spring of 2011 and was used only by 139 motorists in its first 3 months, and as of August 2012 was averaging only 10 motorists a day. It was expected that the traffic would increase when a new bus link was opened to transfer drivers from car park to the station. A new multi-storey car park was on the station site with 710 spaces was opened on the 5th of September 2014 by Baroness Kramer, Minister of State for Transport, and the construction of the car park, which began in mid-2013, caused a short-term lack of spaces for commuters. The car park cost £13 million, was funded jointly by Network Rail and the Department of Transport under the Station Commercial Projects Fund. Improvement cyclist facilities, including a bike hire scheme, were provided in the late 2000s. The station was closed for 2 weeks in September 2017 to allow the upgrade work as part of the electrification and upgrade work of the Great Western Route. Works included resignalling, installation of overhead electrification gantries, and the start of the construction of a new fourth platform on the south side of Platform 2. The new Platform 1 took over the existing goods loop, allowing trains towards Bristol and North Wales to be accommodated at the same time, thus easing a bottleneck. It was opened on the 13th of April 2018 by Chris Grayling, the Secretary of State for Transport, and the other platforms were lengthened to 280 metres at the same time. The station was then closed for another 3 weeks in autumn of 2018 for further electrification works, including the installation and testing of the overhead wires. So let's get started at the other Bristol with 165127, departing with the 1250 Great Western Railway service of Brighton to Worcester Forgot Street. With the cancellation of the 1255 to London Paddington, next up is 800017 and 800034, with the 1303 Great Western Railway service of London Paddington to Swansea.
May I have your attention, please? Customers are reminded to mind the gap.
Working an empty carriage working from Cardiff Central, running 7 minutes late, is 387143 and 387150. Next for cross country is 220025, working the 1321 cross country service of Edward Waverley to Plymouth. Next arrival into the station is 800-308. Work in the 1328 Great Western Railway service from Cardiff Central to London Paddington. And going the other way, still wearing its face covering, is 800-321. Working the 1334 Great Western Railway service from London Paddington to Cardiff Central. Over on the far side sees the departure of 158745 and 158766 with the heavily delayed 1316 Great Western Railway service from Gloucester to Frome. Next up for cross country is 221144 and 220010, working the 1344 service from Penzance to Newcastle. Next behind that is 165128 and 165136, working the 1351 Great Western Railway service from Weymouth to Gloucester. Arriving with everyone getting in the way is 802017 and 802005, working the 1356 Great Western Railway service from Swansea to London Paddington. Working a Tampa move from Rugby DED to Bristol Kingsland Road is DR73907.
Thank you for wearing the face covering if you can.
Next in to arrive is 802113, working the 1404 Great Western Railway service from London Paddington to Swansea.
Platform 3.
And here comes our train in top and tail formation of 43.366 and 43.303 with the 14.09 cross-country service from Plymouth to Birmingham New Street.
First class is at the rear of the train.
Thank you so much for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed what you saw, click on the two videos here at the end screen. Helps out the channel. Also, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe if you are new and got this far. And we'll see you all in the next video, folks, wherever that may take us. We'll see you then, folks.